そしたらちょっと読んでいきます。
はい、
はい、
The Gospel of Luke recorded that John
the old man, old man, okay. Then page 15.
His prison said to ask Jesus whether he will accept
expected the Messiah.
Messiah. Mm-hmm. This was Jesus. This was Jesus. And go back and tell John what you have seen and hear. The
blind man.
Blind can see.
Blind can see.
The dream. Mm-hmm. And talk. The leper.
Talk where?
He
had made it. Leopard, Hansen's病だな made clean.
The leopards are made clean. The deaf can hear. The dead are raised to life. And the good news is preached to the poor.
Okay. Okay. This one's actually talking about Jesus healing, but before Jesus start healing ministry, then they explain to everybody, and the Bible actually said, how about John the Baptist? You know, John the Baptist, you know, one of the guy, he is a cousin of the Jesus Christ, you know, actually. So then he got the prison. So then Jesus, he likes to ask what he's doing. What's Jesus doing? What's his job? Then he is a real Messiah or like just like a human being or something. You know, that's what he asks. So then, you know, gets on this one. But anyway, why don't you just read Matthew Chapter 11, verse 2 to 19. Matthew chapter 2.
Verse 11?
Yeah, yeah. Matthew, just one second, I open up.
Chapter 2.
Chapter 2. Okay, verse 11, okay.
They came into the house and saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. But putting their treasure, they offered to him gifts, gold,
frankincense,
and what is it?
Which was? Mice, yeah.
Mice.
Okay, then keep going.
Being warned in a dream that they should not return to
Herod,
they went back to their own country another way.
Mm-hmm.
Now when they had departed, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, Arise and take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt and stay there until I tell you. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. He arose and took the young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt and was there until the death of Herod that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the Lord to the prophet saying, out of Egypt I called my son.
Okay.
then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked by the wise men, was exceedingly angry and set forth and killed all the male children who were in in what was it?
Bethlehem?
And in
Bethlehem, place, yeah.
And in all the surrounding countryside, from 2 years old and under, according to the exact time which he had learned from the wise men.
Mm-hmm.
And then that which was spoken by prophet was
prophet, right?
Mm, was filled, fulfilled, saying.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 19.
A voice was heard in Lamentations.
Lamentation, yeah.
Weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children, she would not be comforted because they are no more.
Mm-hmm.
But when Herod was dead, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, this is more like a Christmas story. 네, Christmas no story. 네. Then the Herod trying to kill because he's so afraid. Because everybody said Jesus is King of King, Lord of Lord, you know. So then also he's a god or something. He was so afraid because he at the time he was a king. So now then the you know more bigger one, Lord of Lord means bigger than a king. You know, king. So many kings around, you know, Israel area. So that's why he's one of the king. So that's why he's so afraid. Then worry about see what's going on. Yeah. So that's a story about Jesus. Jesus was born. You know, like you know, we are talking about this one. Jesus is the Son of God. Okay. And also at the same time, he's a Son of Man. The very unique guy, this one. So then he actually last time then we just read Matthew chapter 1 and 1, ね? Chapter 1, ね? No, verse 1. そこのところをちょっと verse 1と verse 2. Okay.
いい
ですか? どうぞ。
The book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac begat Jacob, and Jacob begat Judah, and his
brothers. Yeah, okay, so then actually Jesus, then we are talking about now Jesus is a God, but the Bible really said Jesus is a human. So that's why genealogy from the, you know, Adam to Jesus, then the whole way. Adam then created by God. God created Adam as his image, mean the God image. You know, type of the God, but not exactly. But Jesus is a type of the God and also human being. You know, so different. We are human being. You know, so that's why this one's a two part. One part, he is fully God. 全部の神様ね、全体。That's why fully God, right? Son of God and fully God. Another one, then the Son of Man, is a fully human. So once you understand the two part in the Bible, then understand you understand the Bible, and also then why you know Jesus come to this earth? Why you know what's actually reason? And what about the Bible? What the Bible you know mean? So Bible, this one is a love story. Love story mean is a God loves you, so that's why His love story is the Bible, and also we call maybe nowadays you know love letter or something. Once you know after I became a minister, this one you know the Christian minister, then I understand this word you know not quite exactly whole thing, still you know learning you know every day just this book. But this book is more like a love letter to you or us, because God is love, God is a spirit. So then that's why you know this book is a love letter for you. Okay, so then the Jesus is you know part of the you know God. No, you know we have to understand this one's Jesus is a 100% God and also 100% human. Human being, you know, so that's what he's a being anyway, okay. So now we just look at the you know, Matthew chapter 1. Then the you know Bible is very clearly to say 100% God and 100% you know human being. So that's why you know just halfway, half God and half human. No, this one. So that's why very much straightforward. Then our human, we just even a daily conversation, but we are not. Sometimes we are not sure. Then you know, just tell them the make up a story or something like that. But God never make up a story. So this one's Matthew chapter 1:1 said, the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, and the son of Abraham. Then come down, then the son of Mary, and the son of Joseph. You know, all human relate with, you know, relate with the human being, this one. So that's why he's a part of, not a part of the man, no, completely 100% fully, you know, God, that Jesus Christ, okay? So that's what, you know, we have to understand then the situation. And then, so then he's talking about, okay, back to the book this one. So then the John the Baptist, you know, you got to understand that the Bible, then few people, you know, John the Baptist and Jesus Christ at the time, you know, appeared in the, you know, book this one, okay? Now, one just read Luke chapter 7, verse 11 to 35. This one's also tell the when Jesus was born. So then very clearly, human being, as a human being, then he was born the baby, not the pops out then adult people, no, from the baby, just like a human, you and me, same, you know. Look. So that's why chapter 7 verse 11 to 35. Maybe you can help.
11 to
35? Yeah.
and it came to pass the day after that he went into a city called Nain, and many of his disciples went with him, and much popular people, And when he came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, there was a dead man carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow, and much people of the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said unto her, weep not. And he came and touched the bier, and they that were king stood still, and he said, young man, I said unto thee, arise. And he that was dead sat up and began to speak, and he delivered him to his mother. And there came a fair and and they glorified God, saying that a great prophet in reason of almost among us, and that God hath visited his people. And these rumors of him went forth throughout and Judas and throughout and begin round about, and the disciples over John.
Disciple
on John shared him over all three things. And John calling unto him two of his disciples sent them to Jesus, saying, are he that should come or look before another. When the man here came unto him, they said, John Baptist, sent us unto thee, saying, art thou he that should come, or look before another? And in the same hour he cured many of them.
Yeah, he healed many people of the diseases, right?
He could have many of three in infirmities and fled and over even split. And unto many that were blind, he gave sight. Then Jesus answering said unto them, go your way and tell John what thing ye have seen and heard, how that the blind see, the lame walk, the leper are cleansed, they heard that are listened, raised to the full, the gospel in the gospel is preached. And blessed he is whoever shall not be offended in me. And when the messages of John were departed, he began to speak unto the people concerning John, what men yet out into the world is, for to see a reed shaken with the wind.
Okay, it's okay, yeah. Yeah. Whole thing, this one's actually talking about, like John the Baptist, he's a human being. He's the greatest guy ever exist. Okay, now we have Luke chapter 7, verse 11 to 35.
Right. 11 to...
Yeah, 11 to...
35. Okay. Good. So Jesus went to a town called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd went along with him. As he approached the town gates, a dead person was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a large crowd from the town was with her. When the Lord saw her, his heart went out to her, and he said, "Don't cry." Then he went up and touched the bier they were carrying him on, and the bearer stood still. He said, "Young man, I say to you, get up." The dead man stood up and began to talk, and Jesus gave him back to his mother. They were all filled with awe and praised God. "A great prophet has appeared among us," they said. "God has come to help his people." This news about Jesus spread throughout Judah and the surrounding country. John's disciples told him about all these things. Calling two of them, he sent them to the Lord to ask, "Are you the one who is to come, or should we expect someone else?" When the men came to Jesus, they said, "John the Baptist sent us to you to ask, 'Are you the one who is to come, or should we expect someone else?'" And that very time, Jesus cured many with diseases, sicknesses, and evil spirits, and gave sight to many who were blind. So he replied to the messengers, "Go back and report to John what you have seen and heard. The blind receive sight, the lame walk, those who have leprosy are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the good news is proclaimed to the poor. Blessed is anyone who does not stumble on account of me." After John's messengers left, Jesus began to speak to the crowd about John. "What did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed swayed by the wind? If not, what did you go out to see? A man dressed in fine clothes? No, those who wear expensive clothes and indulge in luxury are in palaces. But what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you.' I tell you, among those born of women, there is no one greater than John. Yet the one who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than me." All the people, even the tax collectors, when they heard Jesus' words, because they had been baptized by John, but the Pharisees and the experts in the law rejected God's purpose for themselves, because they had not been baptized by John. Jesus went on to say, "To what then can I compare the people of this generation? What are they like? They are like children sitting in the marketplace and calling out to each other, 'We played the pipe for you, and you did not dance. We sang a dirge, and you did not cry.' For John the Baptist came neither eating bread nor drinking wine, and you said, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and you say, 'Here is the glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' But wisdom is true, right by all her children."
Okay. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. Okay, this is a very remarkable, you know, scripture we're talking about. Because John's Baptist is the greatest man ever seen. That's what Jesus said. You know, God, part of the God said greatest one. But still, look at the story, this one. He actually doubt, you know, doubt come. Then God never doubt, because he got always confidence in everything. So that's why, if you look at the Bible and Jesus, then the 100% God's part, you know, if you see this is a God, we just trust everything. Then the other part, the human, then we don't know exactly what he's talking about. Sometimes more like an inside story of the Bible. So you can't tell sometimes, you know, whole Bible read, you know everything. No, I don't know everything. You know, certain areas still I don't know. You know, Bible, you know, like a 4 years college or another 2 years, and even you study the Bible, you know, 66 books, but still I don't know so much, because behind meaning, inside meaning is a very, very strongly, described. So that's why in the United States we have a 100 different translations of the, you know, Bible. You know, King James, then the 1611. First I got involved in this ministry, then first I read the, you know, King James. I don't understand, so old English, I don't understand. So now we got the new King James and, you know, all other Bible, then at least 100 different one. You know, still, one of the tribe in Brazil, you know, Amazon, they don't have a Bible. People, you know, start just recently, start studying Bible because the language, you know, they don't understand. So then what actually guy did or he's doing right now, you know, go to the Amazon and live together, then understand the word by word. So he translates. Still, we have a lot of, you know, languages need to, you know, translate. But even the translate, but the meaning of the Bible is more deeper than, you know, what we see, what we read. So then that's limited. Because human being, then our human being, then limited, you know, right, translate and everything. So that's why even Jesus speak out word, then sometimes people don't understand. But whenever God speak out, then, you know, more like individually deeper meaning we understand. You know? Yeah. So this, okay. Now, page 15, we just did Jesus the healer. Okay, reason why healing is very important. Then our life, you know, we got the, everybody so many years then study or learning and working and all kind of things. Then but still lots of stuff then, you know, learn until, you know, die. Okay, so lots of area we don't know. Then Jesus himself healed mean. Then the meantime we need healing. Okay, everybody healing. Then our mind, then our, you know, even a body or you know, everybody need go on like our life. You know, so Jesus actually he is a healer. Then he healed then the people, then the emotional problem, then our relationship problem, then the, you know, just like a brother and sister and son and, you know, daughter and the wife and the husband and the grandpa and the grandma and all relationship, okay? Then sometimes we need heal. So Bible clearly said each one of the time, because word itself doesn't tell whole thing, but we got another Holy Spirit then the, actually teach you, show you everything. That's what, you know, like a confidence of the studying the Bible. Okay. Okay, next one we got, you know, keep going, just read this one. Okay. Ken-san. Miracle and sign. Okay, page 16. Miracle and sign. Miracle and sign. You got the old one? 今ないね。OK。OK。
The New Testament emphasizes that Jesus proclaimed God's kingdom to
through the
kingdom through deeds as well as works, and John describes the miracles of Jesus as signs showing the glory of God. Presence for all who wanted to see. The Gospel of Mark say that when Jesus sent disciples and he taught them to do the same. As you go, proclaim the
good news.
The kingdom of heaven has come near at hand
means you can touch, you can cross. Yeah.
At hand, cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. Jesus' teaching and Jesus' miracles were just two signs of the same coin. Kingdom of God is at hand.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, this one, so that we read, you know, previously we just read Luke chapter 7. Verse 11 to 35, she read this one. You know, like I told you, Jesus is God part. Sometimes then we just read the book, you know, this one. Oh, this is 100% Jesus. He's a God part. And also fully, you know, God. And on the other hand, then Jesus is fully human being, human, you know. So then the John's Baptist asked, and he just doubt, you know, asked, and you know, what he's doing, what Jesus doing. He's a really Messiah, you know, he's a great man of the whole world, but still ask and doubt, you know, see what's going on. That's why Jesus said he never condemned, Jesus never judge to the John, then just he said what he said, just look at what I'm doing. I don't need to explain. Just look at. Then the miracle happened, then the dead rise, and all kinds of things, then the, you know, then the reporter, John's reporter, go back to the John. Yeah, he's doing like this. That he's a Messiah, and then he explained. But the end of the whole thing, then the story, this one, then John's the greatest man, then the, Jesus said, then after that, you know, he actually chopped the head and died, you know, no more story about. But his business actually finished at the time. Okay, Then read Mark 1, Mark chapter 1, verse 14-15. Book of Mark, chapter 1, and also 14 and 15. Okay.
That's so hard. Now, after John was put in prison, Jesus came to Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saving the time truthfully, and the kingdom of God is a hand. Depend and believe in the gospel.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. This one's Mark. Mark actually clearly said Jesus' teaching and Jesus' miracle were just the two sides. He is a teaching, mean he teach like a level of our level, you know. Then he teach. Then the miracles, a different story. Different story means that Peter's mother-in-law got sick, high fever or something. Jesus actually touched. Then she was healed. You know, that part, then he's a God. And then he work so much, then he tired, then he's hungry. Like a human part and the whip, you know. Then he showed compassion and all kinds of human being. Okay, yeah. Okay, so next one, page 17. Okay. Okay. Oh, okay. It's okay. Okay. She's going to read care and concern about Jesus.
Care and concern. Jesus' miracles communicate the same underlying basic theme as this spoken message. Just as Jesus taught in the words and the attitude that God loves all kinds of people, so his miracle often involved the outcast of the society. His declaration of God's care and concern was not just talk, it demanded action. Moreover, as the gospel of Mark spells out, healing and forgiveness went hand in hand, and faith also was required of those who would be healed. Indeed, at least one story in New Testament Gospel of Mark implies that the absence of faith could be hindrance to the work of healing.
Okay. Then also I want you to read Mark 2:1-12. Then this one said the forgiveness and the healing are same power. Okay, that's what this one, yeah, okay, read chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. Okay, folks, that page is 17, okay, right now.
Some men came bringing to him a paralyzed Isaac carried by four of them. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd, he made an opening in the roof above Jesus and after digging through it, lowered the mat and the paralyzed man was lying on. When Jesus grew their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Now some teachers of the law were sitting there, thinking to themselves, "Why does this fellow